So how many of you, and that would be you, Fabu, you've heard the word faggot or dyke or gay or tranny or homo, no homo, used negatively, right? You have, right? You have, right, Amanda?
Yes, and I'm not really a big fan.
Yeah, no, me neither. And so we're gonna turn these words on their head, and we're gonna try to associate them with good or silly things instead. You know, so first of all, let's take on the word faggot, which, you know, is an epithet that few have figured out how to combat yet. Now, just so we're clear, a faggot in England is a kind of cigarette, and it is also a kind of meatball, which I think is hilarious.
That's bad.
Right?
That's funny.
That's really crazy.
How do you want your faggots cooked today?
I'd like square faggots. That's what I'd like.
Square faggots?
Like round faggots with Alfredo sauce.
Alfredo sauce. Okay. Medium rare?
So it's also a kind of meatball. It's also when steel workers weld metal stakes together. And faggot is also heard as hate speech in the school hall. But I think there really are so many other things that we can do with the word, you know, and some of them are serious and some of them are absurd. So the next time you hear the word faggot, think of these acronyms instead of the slur. So someone says faggot, they're really looking for help for their friend, like facilitate a gay guy over there, or they're paying you a compliment. Fascinating, awesome, grooving guy, obviously top notch. Or maybe they're confessing. Fine, I'm a goon gone over the top. Or maybe they're saying, Faye, and it's good to be gay, okay, today? Or maybe they're confused and in pain. Fag, I am gay and genuinely overcome with terror. Of course, faggot isn't the only slur heard in the schools. Other linguistic fools like to use words like dyke or lesbo. You've been called a dyke in a negative fashion, Amanda?
Yes, I have.
Yes. It's weird how you can say a word, you can say dyke, like, I'm a dyke, you know, and it's like, it sounds good, and then someone else can go dyke, and it sounds awful.
It all depends on how you say it and who's saying it.
Right?
Exactly.
It's like broccoli. You can say, I'm broccoli, or someone can go broccoli.
Whoa.
Whoa, right?
Don't call me broccoli.
Don't call me, I'm broccoli. So, lesbo is like little egos saying boorish obstinacies. Or, lesbos is like, let's everyone see bullies overturned. Or lesbo could mean lovely, effervescent, simply beautiful organism. And anyone who doesn't like the word dyke has got to deal with me, because I love the word dyke. But if you don't have me to back you up, here's one acronym I think will help absolutely. Dyke, don't you know everyone is? Okay, I know it's sarcastic, but I think it's kind of funny, and it gets down to biz. Newer on the scene, but older than my granny, is the derogatory term for transgendered person, which is tranny. So if someone calls you a tranny, they are clearly jealous of your bravery. And they may be totally supporting, like transgendered and rockin' ace, never know, yo. Or, you know, they could be completely confused, out the wazoo, like trans? Really? Add negatives? Yes? No? Or rather, no? Yes? Train. Not tranny. It's just good to keep them guessing. Or maybe you can say to them, take your really angry, never-ending nonsense yourself. or you can tell them to stop terrorizing really anxious, nervous, needy youth. Because really, you are a totally radical, awe-inspiring, noble, number one you. And just before we get to the last word, a word on name calling in general. You know that the minute we undo one epithet, someone will come up with some word we haven't even thought of yet to use as an insult. So faggot is no longer the worst thing you can call a guy. Now the worst thing you can call him is a girl. So here's your armor. Here's your gear. Here's how you can undo what they want you to hear. Number one, name calling is just plain preschool. If you can remember that, you will wade through it like a kiddie pool. Number two, every word has positive connotations in some context. So if someone calls me stupid, right, chances are I don't want to be smart in what they're good at, which is making fun of people. So it's good to be stupid in that case. Or if someone calls me a man because I'm a lesbian, I would think, yeah, right. And who runs the world? I would totally turn sexism on its head in order to avoid derision. And number three, this one is a bit complex, but if you believe that every one of us has some bit of everyone else in our mix, that identity is not fixed, and that our personalities run a wide spectrum from zero to infinity, from nothing to totality. I'm getting ahead of myself. That identities run through a wide spectrum from zero to infinity, from nothing to totality, then no one can call you anything that they're not also calling themselves. Seriously, they're just trying to work out their own confusion out loud on your dime, and you don't have to pay them any mind. It's all about them. It's their identity problem, and you can go on with your day with nary a conundrum. And just remember to finally always get great, out-of-sight, tight friends, awesome guys and gals who'll oversee your tracks, who'll have your back. Tranny, lesbo, gay, dyke, and faggot. The meaning is just in your thinking and hearing habit. Oh! And gay? Gay, 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 yay, gay! Gay really stands for great, amazing youth, and gosh, are you? And go accessorize yourself.